بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وكذبوا وتبعوا أهواءهم وكل أمر مستقر ولقد جاءهم من أنباء ما فيه مزدجر حكمة بالغة فما تغني النذر صدق الله العلي العظيم. Second year class with the lecture number 29, and today we will talk about the vertebral column, the important structure in the human body, the vertebral column, and of course the vertebral column, 33 vertebrae you already know, 33 vertebrae you have, and that vertebrae that is backbone of your body, that is supporting your all skeletal system. It is present at the dorsal side. Where is the dorsal side? This is the dorsal side. This is the ventral side. So where is the dorsal side? This is the dorsal side and this is the ventral side. This is dorsal side. This is dorsal side. And this is the ventral side. You are getting me? Because the back side, your back side is the dorsal side. I will just tell you once again. Just hold on, because I have to drop this one. Yes. Okay, Ji. So we have to see. Look here. I will drop this one and then I will make figure once again. This is your ventral side. This is your peritoneal cavity. This is your front side, which abdominal cavity. And that is your back side. That is the dorsal side. That is the dorsal side. And that is the ventral side, where the vertebral column is present. Vertebral column is present at the back side. 33 vertebrae you possess, which is protecting your body. Your body is protected by 33 vertebrae. These vertebrae protect you. You are basically look like your house. Look like your house is supported by a lot of steel. In your house, steel is arranged in such a regular fashion during the construction of the roof. You have seen that the steel man arranged the steel in such a way that protect all the house, and the house will be safe. Look at your body. The Creator gave you 33 vertebrae, and you can see number one vertebrae, second one, third one, fourth one, fifth one, sixth one, seventh one, eighth one, ninth, tenth, so 33. Now I will tell you one by one how you can justify this one. The upper vertebrae are called cervical vertebrae. Cervical vertebrae. C-E-R-V-I-C-A-L. Cervical vertebrae. And these vertebrae, which are the cervical vertebrae, they are total number are 7. Total number of cervical vertebrae are 7. You must understand, because your ribs are present in front side, and this is the structure which is present at the back side. That is the dorsal side, and the front portion is the ventral side. And this consists of 33 vertebrae. They are starting from the neck. I am talking about the neck vertebrae. Total number of the neck vertebrae are 7. These are the neck vertebrae. And these are, what are the vertebrae? This is the point. Vertebrae is basically part of skeletal system. And they, why they are present? This is a, they are discontinuous bones or continuous bones? They are discontinuous bones. They are discontinuous bones. Reason I tell you, you need to move your neck towards the right side, towards the left side. Did you note your neck can move towards the right side or the left side? Your neck will move either towards the right side, either towards the left side. Your movement of the neck is just because of these 7 cervical vertebrae. These cervical vertebrae are moving your body towards the, to moving your neck towards the right side or the left side. So these are much significant substantial structures in your body. Reason, if you, there are some animals who cannot see the right side or left side, and they have to move a complete body towards the right side or the left side because they have no cervical vertebrae. Now your point, sir, cervical vertebrae, they are 7 in numbers if I am making these figures, and how they help in movement of the neck. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, because they consist of a joint between them. There is a joint between them. there is a joint between them. Joint mean they are interconnected by a structure which is called as intervertebral discs. I will discuss this in a separate topic, but this is essential to discuss here some points. Look here, if you see this one, this is a one vertebrae, this is a one vertebral column, and this is another vertebral column, and between them there is a cavity, and between the cavity is called between the cavity, and that is intervertebral disc. So seven vertebrae, they are one vertebrae, second vertebrae, third vertebrae, they are attached with each other by a cartilaginous disc. You know, cartilage also the part of skeletal system that is quite soft, and with the liquid, which I will discuss in this chapter, when the liquid is present, and you know that is basically the joint, that is basically the joint. And joint mean that consists of a liquid, and that is supporting your body. Your body will be able to move. That's why the neck is able to move towards the right side or left side. The question was that how your neck is able to move by these joints. Reason is that because there is an intervertebral disc. So cervical vertebrae is very important. These are the vertebrae, are the neck vertebrae, due to which you are able to move your neck towards the right side and the left side. So in the figure I have to show you, you can see this figure, 7 cervical vertebrae with the alphabet C. You can see first one, second one, third one, fourth one, fifth one, sixth one, seventh one. Now this is the dorsal side. This is the dorsal side. So this is the dorsal side. Dorsal side means your back side of the body. Ventral side means your front part of the body. And upper side means your interior position. The lower side is called the posterior position. Upper is interior position. The lower is posterior position. So anterior position, posterior position, the dorsal position, the ventral position. So these are positions are telling that these cervical vertebrae or neck vertebrae are so important, because your necks are moving and supporting your neck. If you can see me without movement of your lower abdomen, reason is that you have the cervical vertebrae. Now I will tell you another vertebrae which are present. Where they are present? They are present in the thoracic vertebrae. Your body consists of second part, chest cavity. First part is the neck. I will make it neck, and the under the neck, with which cavity is present? The thoracic cavity is present. Thoracic cavity is also called the chest cavity. In the chest cavity, significant structures, lungs are present, you know. And then it is a three-story building basically. The lower story, upper story, and then a MIMTI, mean in which the tank is present. So your body just like house. So I am explaining in reference to something that just like house, the thoracic cavity or chest cavity in which the lungs are present. This is the abdominal cavity in which digestive system, main part mean intestine and stomach is present. Liver is also present. So front part, the back side I am talking about, the chest cavity. This is the human body. So here are the lungs. Also the heart is present. Ribs I am not discussing here. I am talking about this dorsal side vertebral column, cervical vertebrae. And then chest cavity back side is called thoracic vertebrae. This whole vertebral column, which is moving from the neck to the down, which I will discuss. Even the tail is not present in the human. That is much interesting discussion, why the tail is not present. Even the tail bone is present. I will tell you the tail bone as well. So, but now I am in a thoracic vertebrae. What are the thoracic vertebrae? The vertebrae with the dorsal side, with the chest bone attached at the chest cavity, at the back side of the chest cavity where the lungs are present. That's why it is called, because it is at the back side of thoracic cavity, because in the thoracic cavity lungs are present. That's why these are all are called as T1, mean thoracic cavity number one vertebrae, Second, two, what are the vertebrates? Because once again, you have a question. These are total number of how many thoracic vertebrates are there? 12, you know. But first of all, once again, I will tell you what are the thoracic vertebrates. Thoracic vertebrates means they have a structure like that, and they are bones. They are just like spines of the bones. And this is another one. And they are attached with each other, a disc which I'm not discussing in this topic, but this is involved with the locomotion because they consist of a joint, and that is called intervertebral disc, which consists of a liquid as well. I am not naming that liquid because you will be confused. That liquid name and membrane name I will discuss in the next topics. So thoracic vertebrates and cervical vertebrates we studied today. This was lecture number 29 for dear second year class. Thank you very much.